I thought today we'd start out tapping right into my blue. Of course, we'll have the colors running down below. And let's go ahead and start out here. Just tap into my blue, and I'm just gonna start doing my X's, and I'm using Phthalo Blue. I have a 18 by 24 inch canvas for today. Not that today we do a lovely painting. I hope you're feeling good and doing good on your side. It's been a little bit. I've had a busy couple of weeks. I am so happy to be able to paint. And if you're painting with me, I'm happy you're painting with me. Let me just tell you. There we go. Just doing those nice little X's. It just seems to, you can tell, it just makes lovely, lovely little sky. You don't really do much. You just tap into your color and then just put some in. There we go. Nice and lovely looking sky. There we go. Maybe just a little bit darker up top. Maybe just a little bit darker. Tap in. Come up here. There we go. It's a nice, beautiful sky. I love those blue skies like this. It just, you know, just sets the mood, I guess you could say. There we go. And I think we'll have a little bit of color down here as well. So same thing, just nothing special, just here and there. We're just gonna use that for some shadows later on. And maybe just a touch into your red. And same thing. And maybe we'll just use it for shadows. That's all it's gonna be, okay? With your filbert brush, and I'm gonna go into a little bit of my Mars black, or you can use whatever black you like. Not too much of this, not too much of your black, but we're gonna go ahead and just kind of make an active sky. And I'm just gonna just come in and just put little touches here there, just like that. Nothing major. We're just gonna go back and highlight and have some fun, but let's go ahead and just get some stuff going here. Maybe something like that. Make it a little bit, maybe just a little bit darker up here. And then that's it. I'm gonna come in and just put these, just doing this motion right here, just rocking motion like so, and just get some action going here. There we go. All right, now I'm gonna go ahead and just rub some of that paint out. I'm gonna go into this white. I had two piles because I knew it was gonna get a little messy in the clouds, and I just don't wanna pollute this one pile yet. So I'm gonna go into here. Using that same filbert brush, just load it up and just come in and there you go. I'm just putting in some nice circles, okay? There we go. You could just put it here, there. We're gonna go ahead and just blend it out anyway, so it doesn't make much of a difference, okay? Sit here and just keep doing your thing. There we go. Man, it's been a while since we painted, so feeling a little rusty. But it's like riding a bike. This takes a little bit and you're right on it. Same thing, just keep putting this little things like this, like that. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and just put this down. And I'm gonna grab my another brush here. One second, this thing wants to roll on me. There we go. And I'm just gonna make sure I have a kind of a clean brush here. And we're gonna go ahead and just start making some circles. Make some circles. There we go. You're just blending, pretty much blending under the cloud. But just going all over, it doesn't matter. Just blend that in there. Blend that in there. Oops, excuse me, got a hair. But as you can see, it just gives you some nice action. You're not really doing much. There we go. And I'll put that down. Now I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna go ahead and go right back into my black here. Same thing, not too much. Rub some of it out. And just come in and just put something right here. And then we'll go back and put some white. Also, I just want some, like a lead cloud going. And I'm just going like that with the brush. I'm not doing too much. Just some nice circles. And I'm just trying to blend out the bottom a little bit. Right into here, okay? And maybe there we go. See? So you get some nice like just darkness, some shadows, kind of stormy looking. And maybe same thing here. Same thing here. And I'm just circles and scrubbing it in. I'm sure you can hear me scrubbing it. I'm just kind of blending out the bottom here. Got a little, just touch more. Just want to. There we go. And I'll go into, let me go ahead and just blend this out a little bit. I'm going to use that 2-inch brush. And I'm just going to come right underneath it. Just get that nice and blended. There you go. And then same thing here. Get some little bit of movement, fluff it up. Same thing here. Just give it a little bit of movement. And let me put this down. I'm gonna rub some of that paint off again. Just got a paper towel down, folded up down below on my easel here. And so I just wipe some of it off and go right back into that white, okay? And I just wanna get some definition. There we go. There we go. Let me grab a little bit more. There we go. And then, just like you did before, just kind of blend it right into there. And I'm not doing much. I'm just kind of touching and sliding it down and kind of letting it blend, but I just want some of that definition of a top of a cloud where the highlight of the sun's on it and then the bottom of it's got the shadow, okay? And just want a little bit over here. Same thing. There we go. And just blend that in. And it just gives you some definition, as you can tell, like some rolls in the cloud, and it just looks pretty lovely. And then maybe just a little bit more. There we go, something like so. There we go. Put that down, and I just want to blend a little bit underneath the cloud. Just under the cloud, just a little bit, just so just blends in the dark and the light underneath, and all you get into that nice crispness on the top. Okay. There we go. And then right under here, it makes it nice and misty. Same thing over here. And there you go. Alrighty, it's been a while. I hope you're doing awesome over there. I just want to say thank you very much if you have taken a moment to subscribe. I hit a personal goal, so I definitely want to thank you very, very much for helping me get there. So thank you again. With that, let's go ahead and pull out our palette knife. Let's go ahead and make up some mountains. So we're going to go ahead and use our Vandyke Brown and just a little bit of this black. And we'll come over here. Well, I can do it right here. And just make a nice little mountain color. Just pick it up, squish it right in there, okay? And you're gonna come in and go that. If you go like this and straight down, you get your nice roll. And let's go ahead and make a mountain. So let's go ahead and we'll just push right in there, okay? That's all you do. Just pull your paint out, pull some out. You want to touch where you want to go and just push it in there, okay? Just something like, maybe something like that, okay? And you just go in there and scrape that stuff out, okay? Scrape the guts. Come in, grab your pile, come back. Maybe we'll have it. Maybe we'll have it something like this. And we'll have it come up a little bit more and then bring down like that, okay? Just like that. Same thing. Like I said, just mainly Vandyke Brown and just a little bit of black. Get some on here and come in and scrape that stuff off. Go ahead and clean that knife. And grab yourself a... I'm going to use a 2-inch brush, and I'm just going to come in and just pull this out. There we go. Just pull it out. There we go. Just like that. Okay. Got ourselves a nice, strong mountain right here. Okay. Now I have an email if you would like to email me some of your paintings. I would love to see them and post them. So I'm going to go ahead and post a couple right now. And I'm not sure if I can do any audio, so I'll just wait on this and just show you a couple of pictures that people have sent. I thought it was pretty cool. People, you know, went ahead and sent me out some paintings, but my email, if you'd like to send it, is mikesfanbrush@gmail.com. And I'll have it in my description, as well as the description of the paints and stuff like that I forgot to mention earlier. So we're just going to go ahead straight, white paint, straight down. Remember, just touch and pull down, get yourself a nice roll, and we're going to come in here and we're going to go ahead and do our mountain. So remember with this, you're skipping a rock or a rock on a pond, okay? If you hit it too hard, it's just gonna splash. We don't want that. We wanna just skip it across the pond. That's how light you wanna touch this, okay? That's how light you wanna touch this. And I'll just start right here, and you just keep all the way down, and then it will break for you, okay? Grab yourself another little pile here, and we'll go ahead here. There we go. Just like that, okay? A little bit more. And same thing. There we go. Okay? Maybe. There we go. And that's it. You're barely touching. You're just letting the paint kind of bounce. That's pretty much all you're doing, okay? Now I'm going to go ahead and let's make a shadow color. So I'm gonna go ahead and just use the same mixture that we made for the mountain there. I'll put it here, and I'm gonna add a little bit of this white, okay? Maybe just a little bit more. Kind of want an in-between color between this white and this dark, and that will be our shadow. And maybe we'll just add a touch of that blue into there. Maybe just a little bit more. Something like that, okay? Come in, get your roll, and then the same thing. Just come in, and then barely touch, and the same thing, okay? Take it, barely touch, and then you'll have that, okay? And maybe we'll have a little bit over here. Just keep this into the shadow. We'll add just a touch of this white, just a touch of this white right here. Just a touch. There we go. So it's like kind of hitting on all angles there. Just a touch more of that white over here somewhere. There we go. Get a nice little break there, okay? I'm gonna go ahead and clean this knife. And we'll grab that same 2-inch brush. I want a little bit of mist in there, so I'm gonna tap into a little bit of my white. And just down below. There we go. And just lift it towards the angle of the mountain. So this way or this way, okay? It'll make it nice and misty. There we go. Let me put that down. I'm gonna grab that knife again. I'm gonna grab some black. I'm gonna go into this color here with some black and make it nice and dark. There we go. Same thing. Pull it down, touch, pull down, get your roll. Okay, let's go ahead and put a little mountain right here. Maybe we'll come in this way. There we go. It's a nice little mountain right in front of it. This one will have a little bit of a dip right there. There we go. Same thing. Push it, scrape those guts out. Clean your knife. Grab your brush again. I'm gonna do the same thing again. Come in. And just pull some of this out. There you go, just like that. There we go. Beautiful, huh? Let's go ahead and put that down. Same thing, grab your palette knife. We're gonna go right back into our white, pull the white down, grab yourself a roll, and come in and do the same thing. You're gonna touch, and then just pull your stuff out, okay? There we go. There we go. Get some nice textures going on. And over here as well. And same thing. Remember, straight down, grab your roll, and then come in and do your highlight. There we go. And then I have some of that shadow color, so just come in over here and put in your shadow, and put a little bit over there as well. Don't want to forget the spot. Same thing. That's it. There we go. And there you go. Let me go ahead and clean that knife. Grab your 2-inch brush again and just come down to here. And I'm just going to mist. It's already misty. So if, I'm going to go ahead and just do it this way. And there you go. Okay, with a filbert or a fan brush, I'm going to go right into my white here. Load up both sides. I'm going to go ahead and just put in maybe a nice little hill or something. And we'll have it come up. Maybe something like that. And you know what? I think maybe let's go ahead and just use a number 3 fan brush. And I want to tap into a little bit of this black and into my brown just a tad bit. And I want to go ahead and just maybe just put in some. All I'm doing is going to touch, just touch and lift up, okay? There we go. And I'll put in some little trees in the background. Maybe some like this that go up in the mountain. There we go. You gotta kind of make sure they go straight up. Maybe we'll pull some of these. There we go. There you go. And by doing that, I don't know if you can see, but you get all these little millions and millions of trees. Just right there. All you gotta do is touch your dark, just lift up a little bit, and you'll get all these wonderful looking trees. Wonderful looking trees. Maybe a couple over here. There we go. Something like that. There we go. And I'm gonna grab and just put a little bit right here. Just like that. I don't know if you can see. I'm sure my hand keeps getting in the way, but you're just touching and going up a little bit. And then I'm going to take my filbert brush that has the white, and I'm going to come under here, and I'm going to start just pulling a little bit. There we go. There we go. There you go. And by doing that, just it gives you a little bit more depth. A little bit more depth. There we go. There we go. Let me put that down. I'm gonna grab that same fan brush here. And actually I want to start mixing up a little bit of color so I have the pile. I'm just gonna use the same dark pile here, and then I'm just gonna add let me use a different palette knife. There we go. I'm going to add some black and a touch of this blue. I'm going to go into here. So it's basically brown, black, touch of blue. Okay. Give me some color. And I'm going to need a little bit more of it. I know I'm just going to need a bunch. So I'm going to grab a little bit more brown, a little bit more of the black, and a touch of that blue. And same thing. There we go. And there we go. I'm going to clean that knife. And I'm going to go ahead and just load up. And I'm going to go ahead and put in something right here. Like maybe there's a little lake. Or a pond, something maybe like that. And I'm going to come in and just put in some trees. Like that. Give it 1 second, I'm gonna go ahead and use a clean brush here. Okay. So we got a nice little line going. I'm gonna grab a little bit more and maybe something like right here. There you go. And then it makes it out. Okay. Grab yourself a clean brush again. Let's grab this other one and then just come in and just right on over it. So hopefully when we get done, it'll look like there's a little frozen lake or something there. Maybe I'll just put this a little bit. There you go. All right, so let's go ahead and grab some of this. And I'm gonna grab, I just went a little bit lighter, so I'm just gonna grab some of this white. Let's put it right there. So I'm using this color here, and I'm just gonna come in here and just lighten it up a little bit. There we go. Just wanna kinda off, just a little bit off from what it is. Okay, and then just come in and let's go ahead and just start putting in maybe a nice row of bushes. Maybe we'll do something where it's, I don't know, maybe we'll start from here and do something like that. Give us a little bit of a line and then just come in and just start doing. Start putting in some trees. Okay, just straight down. There we go. So yeah, it's taken me pretty much 2 years to reach my goal. Wanted to hit 1,000 subscribers. So I want to thank you all so very, very much for helping me attain that dream. It took me 2 years, 91 videos, but I did it. And I couldn't have done it without your help, obviously. So this painting is gonna be a tribute to you for supporting me and helping me reach my dream and my goal. So I just wanna thank you guys. Thank you so much for just taking that time, you know, and hitting the subscribe. I mean, it's pretty cool if you're just gonna just review or check, you know, the channel out with the subscribe as well. It's pretty awesome. So I just want to thank you very, very much for that. Come in and just there we go. Lift some stuff up. There we go. And we got something going there. And I'm gonna go ahead now, and I want to make this nice and dark. I got this little thing there. There you go. So I'm going to use dark color now. And I'm just going to come in and start putting in some pines. So I want my line. I'll make that my line there. And just come in and just start putting in some pine trees. So we'll come in and just do something like that. And then come in and just touch, start working those arms out. There we go. Remember, one side of your fan brush is always better than the other. So just do what you can. Come in, touch. Just start working that out. And let's go ahead and put one maybe right here. Touch. And just start working those arms out. There you go. And maybe, I don't know, maybe put one like a taller one right there. And there you go. Touch, touch. And just start working those arms out. There you go. There you go. Remember, one side's better than the other. You also have some thick paint over here, so you may have to put a drip of some, and I might have to do the same, is just put a drip of some paint thinner. Let me go ahead and just get a little drip, I mean a drip of your paint thinner. And hopefully it'll make things a little bit easier for you. Okay, let's go ahead and maybe give them a friend. There we go. And come in, touch, touch. And just work those arms out. Maybe we'll put another one right there. Touch, touch. There we go. And maybe one right there. And I'm just gonna grab a drip of that paint thinner again. And come on over, and hopefully my shoulder doesn't get in your way. Touch, touch. And just keep working. Working your arms out. There you go. And let's get another one. Here we'll put one right here. And just get those arms out, okay? And maybe another one. Right there. There you go. And I'm just gonna just crunch in a couple darker ones right here just to make it look like it's a little bit deeper. There you go. Now let's go ahead and grab that 2-inch brush. Excuse me, hit the camera there. I'm gonna go into some of the white here. And let's. Get some white up in here. There we go. And same thing here, 1 or 2, there we go, something like that. Try to get some depth, and then maybe something like so. I'm going to try to keep this little red spot in there. I'm gonna put this down. I just want a little bit more detail, more depth. So I'm gonna go and use my filbert brush. And I apologize, starting to get tired. So I'm trying to stay awake here. But get the filbert brush, get some white, and I wanna come in and just start, I don't know, do something. There you go. It just gives it a little bit more. Same thing over here. There we go. And same thing here, come in. There you go, just gives you some depth, some more detail, some more depth. maybe a little bit more over here. There we go. There we go. Let me put that down. I'm gonna grab that 2-inch brush that we were using, and I'm gonna sit here and try to blend this in here. There we go. And there you go. So you got a lot of hills, a lot of depth. Okay. There we go. Let me go ahead and put this down. I'm gonna go ahead and use that fan brush again. I'm gonna go right into my dark color again. A lot of paint. Both sides. Wiggle it up. Okay, I think I'm gonna go ahead and put something right here. Straight down. And touch. Just work one side, come on over. There you go. And let's go ahead and put a big one right here. I'm just gonna grab just a drip of that paint thinner. It's just a little too thick. Right there. And then same thing. Touch. And that's it. Let's push. And there you go. There we go. Nice big old tree. Let's go ahead and load up again. Let's go ahead and get maybe one more here. And remember, we're going to highlight. So don't worry. Don't worry about the detail right now. We will highlight. And maybe a little guy right there. There you go. Maybe one more big one. One more big one over here on the right side. We don't want this one feeling a little bit empty. So same thing. Maybe like that. And remember, touch. And I'll just do the Let me get the other side. Let me get a drip of that paint thinner. Stuff is very thick. That's why I just want to do the one side at a time. It's a little bit easier sometimes. There we go. Sorry, I'm on an angle because of the camera. It's right behind me, so I'm feeling a little bit awkward. There we go. Just want it a little bit. There we go. I think that's good. Let's go ahead and I want to make a little bit of a purple color. Actually, first, let's go ahead and put some trunks in. So I'm going to grab some white. Go over here. a little bit of that Vandyke Brown. There we go, got a nice color there. And I'm just gonna grab my liner brush and go right into here. Straight on up, okay? There we go. And same thing here. And maybe there, real soft and faint. You can barely see it. Real soft and faint. Here. Get this one last one here. There we go. And let's go ahead and just put some little twiggy things here and there. Some stuff like that. Here, just grab a little bit more of that kind of gray color, gray kind of brownish color there, and just put in some little twiggies. Here we go. Something like that, maybe. There we go. Let me clean that real quick. And I'm just going to go into my black, or that dark pine tree color that we made actually, which is black, brown, and blue. And just come in. There we go. Just try to get some stuff in here. Little twiggies and stuff like that. Let me go ahead and get that clean. Okay, and now I want to make a purple color. So I'm going to use my red, put it there, and grab some of this white, and a touch of that blue. And we'll just pick up that gray stuff, don't matter. And we'll take a little bit more of that blue at a time until we get a nice little purple color here. So we got a nice purple color. Let's add a little bit more white to it. There. Trying to get all that red out. So apologize. There we go. Let me clean that. And I'm gonna grab a clean fan brush, and I'm just gonna give me 1 second here to get that clean. All right, and I'm gonna dip into a little bit of my medium. I'm gonna go right into this purple color here. And I'm gonna come in, and I'm just gonna start putting in a little bit of a shadow color on the left side here. So touch, touch, touch to the left, touch, touch, touch to the left, and just, there you go. All the way down to the shadow, okay? Same thing here. And I'll probably just go like this all the way down, and I'll do it all over here too. And we'll just go back with the white, and we'll have it underneath, so it's all right. There we go. Same thing here, I'm just touching and just zigzagging my arm. There we go. Grab a little bit more of that meat. And then same thing over here. more here. There we go. And I'll do the same here. Just here, there, not too much. And same thing here. And same thing there. There you go. Let me go ahead and get this cleaned. Give me a second. Just got my little paint bucket here with the paint thinner. All right, I'm gonna dip into a little bit of that white medium now, and I'm gonna go into my white. Come in and start highlighting. So touch. All right. I don't know if you can see that, but I usually like to go a little bit to the right and then just touch a little bit to the left. Touch, touch, touch. There we go. I'm gonna grab a little bit more of that medium. Excuse me. Get up into my white here. Touch, touch, touch. There we go. Touch, 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 touch. Touch, touch, touch. And then to the left. There we go. There we go, and beautiful, beautiful highlighted tree. Let's go ahead. Let's go ahead and get this side as well. Here we go, touch, touch, touch. Remember, one side is usually better than the other with your fan brush. I have no reason why. I guess it's just how it's manufactured, but it's just how it is. Same thing here. There we go. And maybe just a little bit back there and get that. Let me go ahead and get a little bit more of that medium. Remember, medium, a little bit at a time, okay? Let's go ahead and get this big guy over here. And then we'll work those last couple little ones here. And same thing. There we go. Same thing. Touch, 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 touch. And a couple to the left. And this is that one. It's kind of a little rough for me because I'm a little bit on the angle here. There you go. Takes a little bit more time, I guess, to do it this way, but the detail is a little bit cooler, I guess. You know, whatever works for you, whatever way you can get your pine trees in, it's gonna be perfect, you know. There we go, something like so. I'm gonna come in with that same brush and just come in and just a little bit of this out. Let me clean some of that off. Clean some of that off and just go. There we go. And I'm just trying to blend. Apologize. Anytime I don't talk, it's because I'm thinking, trying to figure out, okay, should I do that or should I not? Or there we go. Maybe a little dark right here. Bring that out. There. And so a little bit over here as well. Let's grab my white. Awesome. I love that. Okay. I'm going to just want one last little thing here. I'm going to grab a small palette knife. I'm just going to grab some of this dark color here. And I just want like there's some rocks or something right there, you know, maybe a little bit over. Something like that. We could take this and I'll just kind of blend that in a little bit. And I'll take, I'm gonna take this filbert brush. Just gonna grab into some of this white here. And I'm gonna take my fan brush. I'm just gonna grab a chunk of this white here. And I'm just gonna put in just a little bit of snow on top of those rocks right there. There you go. I think that's lovely. I'm going to go ahead and take a liner brush. I'm going to go into my paint thinner. I'm just going to go into this dark color here. And I'm going to go ahead and just sign this. I think this is a beautiful painting right here. So let's go ahead and sign it. And just remember, if your paint is nice and thin, it should slide right on over this to your signature. Just make it thin. And since it's, you know, this is white, so I like to go with the black. Black on white, white on black, you know, stuff like that. And it makes it a little bit easier and sticks out. Well, that completes that awesome painting today. A nice little winter scene with the mountains and everything. I hope you enjoyed today's painting. Once again, if you'd like to, hit me up on my email at mikesfanbrush@gmail.com and I'll be happy to post some of your paintings. And once again, thank you so very much. Thanks for your support and I wish you the best. Please take care of yourself. Stay safe. Bye-bye.